Yes, it will publish. So, my name is Rumyantsev Alexander, and I'm the leader of quality components team. And this is a presentation about Tinker Publish. Tinker Publish is a customizable 3D PDF publishing solution for TWG, TGM, and Autodesk read files. So, Tinker Publish based on three main models. First is PDF Expert, second is Tinker PLC, and last is 3D PDF publishing IP. And we provide information about all such three areas, about improvements, and about different other issues. Let's start from PDF Expert. So, PDF Expert is a very old product. This is most popular Tinker Expert. This is product independent expert. It means that we are able to use PDF Expert with Tinker Drawings, Tinker BIM, Tinker Civil, Tinker Mechanical, and so on. So it has about 10 years of development and support history. It means that most of the problems and questions can be found at C++ or .NET forums. You can use PDF Expert also with .NET and Java. The most important step for development of PDF Expert for the last probably 2 or 3 years was integrated 3D PDF support. Previously it was export of 2D geometry to 2D page. Now it is export. You are able to export not only 2D geometry but also 3D geometry to PDF page. But PDF export, this is very popular export, but it has some limitation. For example, you can't place any other elements to PDF contents, and you are limited by Tinker product itself. You are limited by Tinker format, Tinker product format. Some information about improvements. During previous year, we have added a few steps, a few moments related to improvements. First is conveyor optimization. This is performance improvement that we provide the information a bit later. The next point is DPI control improvement. We have added several DPI control related parameters to PDF Expert, like geometry DPI, default DPI, and so on. And you are able to control the quality of output PDF document by using the DPI control parameters. Also, we have supported measuring tool. This is another functionality. And of course, we have continued with their working around 3D PDF support. It was improved. Now it works faster, generate smaller files, and more great files. And one very important feature for ODA found members is that 3D PDF support was carefully tested with STA modeler. There are three modelers in the Tinker. We are able to use free version of modeler to work with 3D entities, C3D modeler and STA modeler. STA modeler based on spatial basis library. And most of our founding members are working with STA modeler in professional products. So we checked it twice and it was very carefully tested. Let me show you some demo about using of measuring tool method. So let's start Tinker device application. Load some 2D geometry file. You can see here some 2D drawing. change the background color probably to white. We can put down this presentation. Okay. So you can see here to be your gym, some wall, we have some door and dimension. Dimension shows that the height of the door is about about 5 meters. Let's export this file to PDF, default defaults, default settings. Default settings means that geometry will be moved and scaled to its edge. But you need to enable measuring clock. Let's export, it's done. And let's check the result. This file. You can see here the result of the PDF export, the 2D geometry is here. This is not the dimension, this is just the result of the export, also 2D geometry. And now let's try to use measuring tool of Adobe. Measuring tool gives you ability to select 2 points of the drawing and calculate the difference between both. You can see here it is also about 5 meters. So now we are able to provide measuring of different issues on the 2D PDF page, for example. This is very useful feature. It was requested by the members. So let's continue with demonstration, with presentation. The next moment I would like to discuss is performance. I said that we have redesigned a creeping conveyor PDF export, and this optimization gives some bonus in performance. You can see here performance graphic. This correlation will be between previous release 4.2.2 and between latest uploaded to web TV release. We have a very huge file collection, about 4,000 files to be used for performance checking. And let's say that blue line is 100%, it is performance of files in Tiger 4.2.2. So, and green curve is performance of the same files in the latest release. You can see here that we have some set of files with very high performance. Most of the files give a bonus about 20%, and some files have a slowdown of performance. This is not a regression in performance, but the reason for such results is GPI control optimization. We have added more careful support to GPI control, and some entities should be exported with more points, for example, in more GPI and so on, so GPI control is more accurate. If you have more points, more GPI, you will lose the performance. And this is the reason of such effect. For example, PDF underlay entity, exported to PDF will be exported like image. The previous release was 72 dpi always, but now it is controlled by bitmap dpi, and by default it is about 200 dpi. So we need more size, and performance is slower. So that's all about PDF export performance. Continue with TigerPRC. TigerPRC is SDK to read, write, create, modify, and render PVC files. So we supported all operations related to standards. And also we have provided full support of PVC standard project with ESO. PVC file standard was published as ESO standard. And in this release we have supported all available functionality in this ESO standard. And one important note is that TigerPRC is compatible with Tiger kernel and compatible with Tiger philosophy. It means that if your developers are working with Tiger drawings, for example, it will be very easy for such developers to start looking with ticker pair C. Because we have the same code style, the same rules, and the same action. Ticker pair C improvements. The first and main, probably the main improvement is public interface optimization. We have there's a very active group of members who are using TWRC, and members asked us about to simplify different moments of PLC standard itself. Some moments of PLC standard are quite difficult for understanding, and we have provided more simple public interface to look with such features. Also, we have added support of compression and decompression of tessellation. Of course, we are now able to render compression and tessellation. And it was the last point which was supported in the previous release related to rendering. Now we have supported all possible entities in TWRC and able to render reps, compressing reps, tessellation, and compression tessellation. And important note about support of ODA members. We have, of course, we have several applications, and we provide direct support of ODA members related to PLC, TWRC. This is a link to PLC forum, and the typical situation when the member asked some question at PLC forum, how to do something, or how to use this functionality. We not only provide answers to the forum, but also add some debug code into debug into example application. Such examples can be started in TV debug application. So you can see that this is TV debug by registered comments. So this list of comments is just answers to the questions of the members and forums. It also very good because you don't need to support your code if something was changed in public interface. We just support it at our site. Now let's continue with main feature is 3D PDF Publish IP. This is new TIG IP which was released in this release. In fact, this is PDF WMF constructor with support of user interface controls on PDF page. Also, you can put to PDF page 3D PDF view and small note. It was integrated with TIG Visualize. TIG Visualize is also a new TIG product. In fact, this is direct access to TIG graphic system. I will provide some information later. So, how to use TIG Publish with TWRC. This is the most simple case. You just need to create some PLC file with TWRC, put it as input to some TWRC published code, because you should write some code which will put some elements to the PDF page, and TWRC published will create for you PDF file. Let me show you some demo about it. So let's start TIG debug application again. And now we start some comment from this comment was created by member request how to create complex topologies. And this is the result of this comment. This object is the result of this comment. Now let's publish this 3D entity to for example, case 2. That's all. And let's check the result. This is Adobe Reader. You can see the result of publishing. It was, this drawing was created by some sample code. You can modify it according to your needs, but this is a good demonstration of images. So you can see here 3D view with our model. You can see here some user interface, interactive user interface, and you can switch, for example, different views. Also, you can see here batteries on the right side with different parts, and you can highlight different parts of this freedom model. I have more interesting demo, so let me load some pre-created file. It takes more time talking about such type of demonstration, but this also similar left page with some 3D entity inside. You can select different views, you can select different paths. The difference between this sample point and the previous one property list. If you select the patch of a 3D entity, some attached to this patch, information will be posted to the property list. It was also requested by ODA members at the OC forum. How to use Tiga Publish with our Tiga products, like Tiga Drawings, for example, Tiga BIM, Tiga Civil, Mechanical, and so on. Now, the scheme is more complex. Database here is Tiga database, and you need to create some PLC file. How to do it? You can use PDF Export special mode, and PDF Export will use a few features of new features. The first is filter mechanism. This mechanism will allow you to select entities which should be exported as 3D to PLC format. Also, you need PLC core itself and some PLC conversion model. We have two types of PLC conversion models. First is a common conversion model, which can be used with all products by default. And also we have product-specific conversion model, because sometimes if you have information about database, you are able to generate PLC files more effectively. So this second step will generate one or more PLC files as output, and after it you can use some sample code to generate PDF output. Let me provide you some demo about it. Let's start Tiga Debug application and load some 3D model. This is some 3D model. I would like to note that we are working here with SP modeler, not with free Tiga modeler, but with partial basis modeler. I also need to load demo commands here. And let's start publishing process. I need to select entities to be exported. And export to PDF, punch to PDF. That's all. Let's check the result. So this is another PDF file. You can see here the same view with entity, but also we have added here arbitrary geometry. This is not created from this entity to geometry, but just example, like you are able to put anything to PDF page, not only the 3D view, user controls and so on, but also you are able to put different types of 2D geometry to a page. So, it was a demonstration how to work with DWG files. Now about using of Tiga Publish with Tiga Drawings for DGEN files. Let's start GDBBAS application again. Load some sample files. Load, we say, example module, if comments. Revert this model, give us some identity, a set of identities, and now we should select entities to be published. Let's wait a few seconds and check the result. This is the result of web publishing of some 3D geometry from DGM file. So this document consists of two pages. The first page you can see default view, and on the second page you can see four additional views, left, right, top, front, back views. It means that you are able to create not single point, single page PDF files, but also multiple pages PDF files. And in this example, we have included PLC model only once, and it can be viewed on two pages five times. So, and the last one demonstration about using of Tiga Publish is using with Tiga Publish with Tiga B, which is quite a different format, so it requires additional effort to support. Let's start Tiga Debug application again. Load some demo file. Let's try to render it. And load the same again. Model with comments. It means that we can share comments between different Tiga products. So there is no selection beam. So we just export the raw model. The raw model to so let's check the result again. File was created. And this is a simple video file which will be created by the publish code. You can also use user interface here. And so this is 3D house. How do you use Tiga Publish with Tiga Visualize? Why we need this step? Because Tiga Visualize is in fact direct access to Tiga rendering system. So you can visualize any custom data. It means that you can visualize any custom database if you have bridge between this format and Tiga Visualize API. So it means we that if we are able to add Tiga Publish support to Tiga Visualize, so we can use it with any file format. And this is quite similar to the previous one, just we need to have this bridge between custom data and Tiga Visualize. And after it, you can use PDF-Export. PDF-Export will generate a PLC file and some Tiga Publish code. Let me show you some demo about this. This is Tiga Visualize viewer, which was in the previous presentation. Let me load some
file here.
I will load the SAT file because we have a bridge for visualizing for SAT files. But it can be, for example, PDF file. If you have a bridge, how to visualize it, TV visualizer. So if you have such bridge, for example, you can use Visual Fidelity Apply SDK to get geometry from PDF page. You'll be able to publish this PDF page to PDF and it will be PDF page inside PDF page, for example. So it means that you are able to use publish TV visualizer with any file format. So this is free entity, SAT file, and let's just export it to PDF. Let's wait a few seconds. It needs to be rendered 6 times. And this is the result. So we say result as previous one. And probably the last moment is some Giga publish sample code. So it has the same kind of style like other Giga products. The same, there is these smart pointers and so on. So it will be very easy for developers to start working with Giga publish. And this is example how to create a single page PDF file with the subject image. So you just need to create a main object publisher. You need to create a document, set some properties for the document like after, document name and so on, and create a PDF page, provide information about PDF size, page size, orientation. So this plot will add page to the document. And next piece of plot will create some image from this file and put it to this location on the page. So it's quite easy to use Giga Publish. And the last line will generate PDF file from this. So if you was working with Giga products, you see that the code is very similar. For Giga Drawings, for example, or Giga Giga. So that's all from my side. If you have questions, please ask me.
And what is the role of the selected 3D modeler in process of 3D publishing into PDF?
You can, this is very how to say how to. You should, if you have a 3D drawing, it may include not only a single 3D model inside, but a few different 3D models. For example, you can select, this is not selection on the user interface, this is selection inside the code. This is filtering mechanism. So you can, for example, if you have a car model, you may be able to select the view to be viewed in the first view, glasses in the second view, and so on. If you have one model, you can provide such information for publish, which part of this drawing should be placed to which view, how it should be organized. Also, you are able to load different database, for example, different DDLG file, and select different units in this file and put it to a different view. So this is just ability to customize 3D views on the PDF page. Which part of this model should be placed to which view, and what part of the now model should be placed to our page, for example. So this is.
So.